Right now we're going to talk about using our fingers when we're playing. So a couple rules about playing with fingers. First, we need a straight wrist. We don't bend our wrists when we put the fingers down, otherwise it makes it very difficult to really be on your tips and to move fast. So straight wrist. Our thumb is going to be where there's smiley on the tape. It's across from your pointer finger, one. Your pointer finger right here, one. And remember, when you put your fingers down, you want to place them curved. Curved onto the strings, onto the tape on each string. So the first tape, which would be about right there, that's where my pointer is going to go. The second tape is where tall man, your middle finger, is going to go. And the third tape will be where your ring man, your third finger, will go. Notice that I still keep my wrist straight. This never bends and touches the violin. Your wrist doesn't touch the violin. Nice straight arm. The only other thing is we need to make sure we keep a little space where the webbing, we call this the webbing of our thumb, is. We don't want to choke up on the neck and then there's no space. We need to keep a little bit of space, and we call that the mouse hole, okay? Let's try. We're going to play an A major scale, and we're going to go quite slow, okay? We're going to play two notes on each bow, or two bows on each note. And then we're gonna put a finger down. We're gonna take some time to really make sure your finger is right on the tape, you're on the tip, and you're using some good weight to push the string down. Because you could have your finger on the right spot on your tip, but if you don't push the string down, you'll get this kind of sound. And we wanna avoid that quite a bit. We wanna have a nice clear tone. So let's try this. We're starting on A first. Two A's, one, two, ready, and two open A's. Okay, now we're gonna put down one. We're putting down our pointer finger on the first tape. Let's play two of those. A1, ready, play. Okay, and now we're gonna keep that finger down, and now we're putting down our middle finger. We're adding A2 on the second tape. Really make sure it's just on top of that tape. One, two, ready, play A2. Okay, keep those two fingers down. Now we're putting our ring finger, third finger, right next to it on the last tape that we have. Let's play A3. Ready, play. Okay, and now we're gonna lift our fingers up and we're going to the E string, no fingers. Ready, play open E. Okay, now we're gonna put down E1 right on the first tape. Straight wrist, good thumb position, good posture. E1, let's play two of them. Ready, go, E1. Keep one down, add two now. Ready, play two. Keep two down, and now let's add E3. One, two, ready, go, three. Okay, now we're gonna work backwards. Start on E3 again. One, two, and three on the E string are all down, straight wrist. Ready, play. Okay, now we're gonna lift up three, and now we have one and two down. Let's play two E2s. Okay, lift up E2, now we have E1. Now lift up open E, I mean E1, now we have open E, no fingers. Remember, when you lift your fingers up, you don't want to have them way back here. Just have them curved, kind of like a helicopter flying in the air, ready to land on the ground. All right, now we've moved to the A string, A3. Put one, two, and three on the A string. Nice straight wrist. See my fingers? One, two, three are down on each tape. And let's play A3. Ready? Play. Lift up three, now we have A2. Bow needs to be on the A string, go. Lift up two, now we have one. Ready, play. Lift up one, now we have open A. And that is the A major scale. There's gonna be another video where I don't spend as much time talking about this, but this is our first introduction to using fingers using the A major scale.